So although here at the CCSA, there has similarly been a healthy amount of debate, and certainly all the agencies represented at the CCSA are keenly aware of the strong desire to relax many of these measures.
Hello and welcome back to Living Abroad. In today's video, I'm going to give you the latest highlights about the CCSA meeting that just took place today, February 21st, about the upcoming anticipation about, you know, reducing some of the restrictions, as well as Phuket wanting to be the first province to declare an endemic and Australia fully opening for tourism. My name is Alex, and you can live through me. All right, so let's jump right into it. So today the CCSA met, and although there wasn't any information about, you know, reducing any of the restrictions, they did mention that by Wednesday the 23rd, they're gonna give us an update about what's gonna happen. So they do understand, they hear us, they know that people really want these restrictions to be dropped or removed or like decreased in some way. So they're feeling the pressure from all angles, from different ministries and the health ministry, tourism authority, Air Asia, airline companies, and just everybody in general is getting fed up with these restrictions because most of it doesn't make sense. So I think they're listening and hearing us. Hopefully by the end of Wednesday, we'll have some information about that. And Australia has opened its borders to international tourists. It's been a long time since they've accepted anyone to the country. So that's great. And if you're unvaccinated, you can travel, but you have to quarantine for 14 days. And last piece of information, before I show you guys the full highlights or some of the highlights of the CCSA meeting, is that Phuket wants to declare endemic. So what does that mean exactly? Let me tell you what that means. So the province of Phuket wants to be the first province in Thailand to declare an endemic. Now, what does that mean exactly, right? So what does that endemic mean? Phuket officials want to declare COVID-19 endemic even as the infection rates are rising in the southern island. According to Bangkok Post report, Deputy Governor says that achieving the endemic status would allow officials to focus on the economic recovery. Local officials would also like to get rid of the daily reporting of the new infections, instead to only be reporting COVID cases involving moderate to severe illnesses, right? That kind of makes sense. Phuket would be delighted to be the first province to declare endemic. A province can declare a COVID-19 endemic if the infected rate doesn't surpass 10,000 new cases a day, the fatality rate doesn't surpass 0.1%, and over 80% of high-risk people have had at least 2 vaccine doses. So let's see what happens with that. I hope they're successful in declaring endemic and other provinces like Bangkok and Chonburi or whatever else can follow as well. Now I'm gonna show you some of the highlights of the CCSA meeting that took place today. Before I do that, guys, if you found this video informative, take a quick second, hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already. Now here is some of the highlights.
Sawadee ka and good afternoon. Thank you for tuning in today to our weekly English language briefings from the Center for COVID Situation Administration, or CCSA. Today is Monday, the 21st of February, 2022, and this is the first of our regular 2 English language briefings for our English language audiences this week, noting, of course, that we may also add additional briefings if necessary. In any event, our second briefing for this week is scheduled for Wednesday, the 23rd of February, 2022, at the same time, directly after the general CCSA meeting that will be chaired by the Prime Minister. As you know, last Thursday's briefings, both Thai and English, were cancelled, but please rest assured that my team consistently and regularly monitors all important developments, whether or not we go on air. And the various working groups under the CCSA certainly continue to do their work, so we will make sure to include any and all important updates for you in the following briefing. So let me turn now right away to a summary of notable points raised just now in the Thai briefing for you. The CCSA meeting this morning continued to monitor the global COVID situation, the overall trend globally reflecting that new cases of infections are on a downward trend, with some countries, however, being a notable exception. The fatality rate, in any case, at the global level remains stable. Many of the countries that are relaxing most, but not all, of their COVID prevention measures have thankfully passed their latest Omicron peak. In Thailand, however, we are not there yet, as we are witnessing every day higher numbers of infections. In Asia, in fact, and a number of countries were mentioned this morning, such as the ROK, Republic of Korea, and others, that trend is upwards. So although here at the CCSA, there has similarly been a healthy amount of debate, and certainly all the agencies represented at the CCSA are keenly aware of the strong desire to relax many of these measures, the officials are at the same time looking very closely at various predicted scenarios for our domestic situation in terms of when exactly that peak would come. So we will, of course, keep you updated and well informed of any further adjustments on the various COVID prevention measures. So again, for Thailand, the cases of new infections, especially those with severe symptoms and the fatality rate, are all on an increase, with the majority of those being a mix of those over 60 and some unvaccinated. Provinces in the northeast and south of the country have witnessed a worrying trend, with cases of new infections there on an acute rise. Risk factors remain in-group dining at restaurants and other venues, close contact with colleagues and classmates, and large gatherings, including sporting events, funerals, and weddings. New clusters continue to be found in schools and as well in markets, with the latter found in smaller clusters. Risk factors for markets and restaurants can be attributable mainly to a failure to comply with universal prevention and COVID-free setting measures. ATK first and home isolation first remain the go-to method for dealing with the current Omicron-led wave. Let's turn now to the usual slide that we have up for audiences at home to have a look at the general situation in the country. And we have new confirmed cases today through PCR testing only.
There you go, guys. So that was the highlights of the CCSA meeting today. If you want to check out the full video that's packed with other information that might be useful for you and your travels, as well as some reimbursements, talking about having money for reimbursement, things like that, there's a lot of good information in there. Check out the full video in my new channel, which is related to just news, solely news here at Traveling Abroad. So just click on that there. Go ahead and check out the full video. I'm going to release a full English summary on that channel, so you can check that out. And that's it for today, guys. So if you found this video helpful in any way, shape, or form, if you want to show your support for living abroad, you can hit the subscribe button. You can subscribe to my new channel, the news-only channel. Or if you really want to show your support, you could buy me a coffee. That would be great, too. If not, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys tomorrow, hopefully with some actual travel videos. See you then. Bye.